Hey everybody, this is Ann Clemmer, and guess what? It is finally Friday. I am so happy to have you here. I'm so happy that you made time to hang out with us. We are going to have some fun getting some ink on our hands. Hopefully not. I'm here with Stamper from stamperdog.com. Let's get started. Stamper, come. Well, as you can see, the director is missing. Yeah. He'll be here. Oh, golly. I think I've got the fan too high. Let me see. I'm still learning these things. You know, got to get a new gadget every now and then. Right now, I'm thinking about getting a gadget, a new lens for this up here. Because, you know I look good. Yeah. Oh, Jacqueline's here from Australia. So it's morning. And golly, it must be early morning. Because I know when Linda Dahlke from our Master Stamper group got on live with me, she had to get up pretty early in order to be live with me. And yeah, that was fun. So Kathleen's here, Nancy. Well, you know, you're all here. I would call you all out, but then, you know, all those people watching it on the replay, and hello to you too, they'd be going, okay, I missed her. I miss that. You know, she made it. I didn't. Yeah. So that doesn't mean I love you any less. I still do. Yep. So, hey, I want to talk about a couple things about organization and this card. You know, I showed it to you the other day. I'll sneak that cough drop in there. Oh boy. Yeah. So how are you doing today? And I want to ask you, what is your favorite Christmas carol? And I promise I won't sing it. Okay. You know, there was a picture I was going to show you, but it might be a little, yeah. We're in a bit of change-up mode, and I get these ideas like, I don't know, when everybody else is having Christmas dinner, I'm thinking, I think it's time to clean my stamp room. Yeah, I'm a little weird like that. Yeah, everybody, you know, my husband will be out Thanksgiving. Yeah, if we don't go anywhere, he'll be out there watching football, and I can have football in on here, and I'll be cleaning my stamp room happy as a clam. 67 degrees in North Carolina. Hold on. Weather report. You know, you can't see that because it's not in view right there. That's going to give the weather report. But I have to remember to look at it at the right time. Right now it's telling me how many people have subscribed to us on Facebook, have liked us on Facebook. And, you know, the dog does like it when people like him. You know, he's just kind of that guy. Okay, so we've got Marcy down in Texas. Here's her favorite. And then Susan and Chrissy like this one. Did it go up? No, it did not. So I'm going to try. There it goes. There it goes. That's Susan and Chrissy. Oh, that would be interesting. Somebody told me whenever she hears Mary, did you know, makes her cry. And you know, they do that every Christmas Eve. So, let's see. I was going to show you a picture of things that you will not believe what I found on my stamp table. I mean, it's this area right over here. Right. And, I didn't take a picture all the way, but remember if you were here on Wednesday, I gave you a little sneak peek of this new paper holder that I got. Well, let's see. Did I bring it in yet? I think I did. I think it's right here. Yeah. So that might not look that clean to you. And I've got to tell you, it would be so nice if my desk was just about 2 inches deeper, because I'm going to have to, just to the right of that is my paper cutter. And that little paper cutter is what I use all the time when I'm here by myself. But when I'm doing something for a kid or a class, then I have a larger paper cutter. And so anyway, and there's my big cut and emboss machine. And then, you know, I may still have room for the other one. I don't know. We're still, but that might not look like a lot. Now, you'll see in the, on that second shelf, there's a wooden box, and that's just for my punches that are in the mini catalog. So like they're right here, and I could put my hand on that box. That's how close I am. So that while that might not look cleaner, it really is, because for me the paper holders, I do have a, oh golly, can I bring that in here? I'm not sure. I do have a paper tower. I do have a paper tower. One tower is for 8.5 by 11. The other tower is for 12 by 12. The only thing is I noticed that when I put my designer series paper in there, yeah, it was great. It was out of the way. And guess what? I didn't use it. So I need to have it someplace where I use it. Yeah. I'm always trying something different. And if you remember what I just put up, which come on, I know you've blinked several times since then, but the one on the right, yeah, the one on the right is the things from the designer series paper from the annual catalog. One on the left has the holiday catalog and the incoming celebration and celebration and January to June. January to June. Yeah, there's got to be another name for it. Hey, so, you know, I'm going to remind you all of something. First we'll start off with this little ditty. You're going to love this. I hope you will. There you go. It's just a bad day, not a bad life. But the look on her face. See, I've been holding this that long for you. Oh, golly. See, Kathleen gets it. Kathleen gets it. And also, I want it to where I can easily go down and I don't know why I feel like I have to have the heat tool right next to me, because I don't use it as much as I do the cut and emboss machine. But is this? Yeah. Yeah, it's funny. Now, see, we can't call it spring because... it's not spring all over the world. And, you know, we are a global company. We're in a lot of different places. So we got to come up with something else. Now, holiday, I think for sure it's holiday. Yeah. Hey, we could call it the beginnings catalog. No, we have a beginner thing too. So, yeah, right. So remember when we brought this out and I watercolored this. And if you look at Wednesday's live stream... And we need to call it like Stamper Dog Live, except for he's still not here. I'd like to know how he gets a day off. Hold on. He's sleeping. I got the official word. He's sleeping. So anyway, when we were doing this, and I got to tell you, you got to get some of our watercolor papers really high quality. You won't have more on hand than you need to. And because it's smaller usable bits, you might find a cheaper one that's in a big size, but then you're going to have to store it. So remember that, you know, yeah. Things are either cheap or convenient. I like convenient if I can afford it. So, okay. Here we go. Yeah. I have so many pictures of him sleeping. He used to be really good and it was great when his eyes were clear, you know. Now, yeah, he sees better than he hears. But back to this. Okay. Now, remember how much green I had? I had green on my hands here. It was just not... Oh... That's a good spot. Here, Lisa's got an idea. You know what? And maybe in between Christmas and New Year's, we'll get back to our somewhat annual organizational thing. And if you want to send me, hey, yeah, here's the deal. Send me your pictures of what's your best organizational tip. Because that shelf that I showed you is actually a shoe shelf. And I know somewhere I've got a link to it and that Kay used it. And we've got pictures of Kay's. And so sometime between now and Christmas, if you think about it, just take a little picture and explain to me why this works for you. Because what something might work for me and not for you. Just like separating your papers and your stamps and everything between what catalog. Well, as a stamper, that really means nothing to you. As a demonstrator, that means everything to me, right? So, yeah. So some things, you know, you might think work for you might work for somebody else, and they might not work for me. But I'm happy to share them if they at least make sense. You know, like if you say, I staple my stamps to the ceiling, I'm going to say, yeah, we're not sharing that one. Nope. So anyway, do you remember how dirty this thing was? Look at that. It's got a little green tint to it. But I mean, that puppy was that it was like solid green. This was. And so what I did, I didn't do it during the show. But I went and, you know, I rinsed it out, which and the other thing, if you're going, it's not coming out. Push, whoa, don't do it now. Push the water from inside the, golly, what are they called? They're called water painters or something different. The other water brushes, yeah. Anyway, push it from here and it will flow out from here and into, you know, and then clean that out. That's all down there at the base. That's stuff that I have a hard time getting out of there. Yeah, when I'm doing paintbrushes, so I have my husband clean them. Isn't that great? But then he doesn't paint. I do the painting. He does. Yeah, he does all the great stuff that allows me to do it. But anyway, that's how you clean these. And when you're, this is a new version. And when you're putting them in, I try to be careful about how I put that in. To get all of that in, right? And normally it would be wetter, so it'd be easier to do this. But you want to get that all the way in there. And then remember that because these are different, these are our brand of them. These ones, what's really great is look at how fine that tip is, right? And you get three for the price we used to pay for two, I think. But I think it's cheaper per pen. Let's put it that way, or brush. But they're different sizes. I think these two sizes are the same, but this big one definitely has its own cover from the barrel. It says push. Yeah, push. Yeah, push from the barrel. So anyway, yeah, yeah. You know, I have easiest way to do this. And I would not do this if you had, I would not do this if you had children. Sorry, it's not a great picture, but you'll get it. Don't, come on. It's not flipping. Oh, there it goes. Don't do that. That works for me, but I've almost got my foot and I've almost got the dog. So, you know, yeah, where it would be a better spot, it would be as far as having hanging hooks, it would be better to for me to have them on the rolling cart. However, I'm just afraid only because they have dropped. What I also put on these is the mini glue dots and the tear and tape. Yeah. Okay. So I'm getting ahead of myself. So today's picture, and oh my goodness, this is going to make me look like rather buxom here. Oh, I see what's going on here. Hold on one second. This is going to zoom right in. Huh. Okay, try that. Okay, that is it. Anyway, I had these made for my my team. You know, I designed them, and then anybody wanted them, I got them. But isn't that a great saying? Imagine with all your mind, believe with all your heart, and create with all your might. Yeah. We're getting a little esoterical. Is that the right word? That's a college word. Okay. You know, now I know Marcy would know. Marcy keeps me straight on that stuff. You know, we're getting so woo. Yeah, Laura. Just, you know, if you're thinking of, you know, sending me a picture for your organization idea, make sure that it's close. Yeah, here it is. Make sure that it's close and that, you know, it's in focus, because it's going to blow up to a pretty big thing picture for people to see it. Right. And then, and you know, just give me a little verbiage and then send it in the email, and not to please don't do Facebook Messenger, you know, because those things are just too hard to find when I need to find them. Yeah. Don't ask me how I know. Yeah. So, today, I was getting, wondering what to do, because I have been, and I didn't show you the last picture. Okay. Hold on. Someone watching this on the replay is probably going, is she ever going to shut up? Well, finally, yeah, I will. As soon as I show you, you know, that shelf, well, when you think, if you think I didn't write, like, you know, like it doesn't look that clean, this is all the stuff I pulled out of that shelf. There you go. It's on a long, skinny table. Yeah, all that was on that shelf. And I'll find homes for it. See some of the past projects. Yeah. So yeah. So, you know, sometime today or sometime this weekend, go and start your plans for, what you're going to do after the gift giving season ends. And then you get into the, oh my goodness, Valentine's Day is right around the corner. But before that, you're going to get into that organizational stuff. Yeah. So it's just going to be easy card today. Easy peasy. I was going to go with this, because I found this guy, he's been flying around my trimmer, or not my trimmer, but my cutter, right? He's been flying around my cutter, and I need to make something with him. And then, here, Whisper White. See here, this is what I haven't said in notes. You know, they made the video private from Stampin' Up, and so they knew this was coming, but I don't know if you can believe this, but when the first thing out of the video was, well, I'm sure you heard that Whisper White is retiring. What? This is like the best cardstock to stamp on. I mean, you cannot find stuff this good. This and our Very Vanilla. Thank you. The Very Vanilla is still here. But apparently, you know, businesses, small businesses, even mine, are having challenges because of, you know, everything going on health-wise. And it's very scary. They say down in LA, like, somebody passed away every 20 minutes from COVID. So wear your mask. And someone I spoke to this morning, who shall remain nameless, but I know you're watching, you know, I mean, she was around someone who she thought just had the sniffles. Turned out they'd been tested. So don't be thinking that, oh, well, I like them and I know they're careful. That means that they can't infect you. You know, and not even be trying to. They're thinking they're doing the right thing. You're thinking you're doing the right thing. I think I'm doing the right thing. We just got to be careful. I mean, really careful, because hopefully we're riding the top of this wave and it's going to get better. So anyway, because of that, the people who make our Whisper White have gone out of business. And I guess they got short notice, but they did test some other papers and the new one, but they don't want to just go and switch it and say, okay, this is our Whisper White. because there's something about this stuff that it is, it's very, very smooth. It's an ultra smooth cardstock. And so, you know how there's whites, that there are different whites, right? You know, some whites look yellow, some whites look blue. And when they're, and that's with every color. I don't know if you realize this, but every single color has either a blue or a yellow tint to it. It'll lean more one way than the other. So it's not really a four seasons thing. It's if it's more blue, it's cool. And if it's more yellow, it's warm. That's pretty much the way it is. And that's why even when you're matching up a white and a black, like this has got to be a cool black because this is a cool white. And what they said was, for a while, you know, there's going to be a little bit of, you know how it is, change isn't always smooth, right? So they're going to, you know, so like I tried to get some thick Whisper White last night and I could not, it was gone. But when the basic comes in, then I'll be able to get some. Yeah. So, you know, they're just, yeah. You know, I mean, it's just, we all have to be careful and tune in at 1 o'clock, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And, you know, hey, that will cure all your ills. In fact, you know, okay, you know, put your head up there towards your screen. We're going to test it. Yeah, hold on. Oh, well, I let it go too quick. It said not out. I'm doing it through my hair and that's, yeah, no, but I do it. Yeah, you know what? We should do that anyway. Don't, you know, don't wait for just the big things, you know, keep in contact all the time. So anyway, the new basic white, right? And for a while you might be able to get both. Like in some things you'll be able to get basic and the other ones you'll be able to get white. And if you put Whisper White, and if you put them side by side, yeah, you're going to notice it. So, you know, well, I think because I don't have any basic white yet. So my recommendation is have enough Whisper White on hand to last you like the month, because I would like to think that they're going to have that, because they've known about this at least 30 days. And I know it takes time for things to get made. And I know it takes time for things to get shipped. But if everybody goes, okay, that's as much Whisper White as I need for 30 days, we'll be fine. But if everybody goes, oh my goodness, I got to get it before it's gone, then, you know, guess what? They're probably going to run out. And then we're gone. It's not going to be pretty. Yes. Marcy. Okay. I thought I covered that. Yeah. They're coming out with basic white. Now, basic white, they said, is a little bit cooler than Whisper White. Okay. So you may or may not be able to tell side by side on the, to be safe. Once you get it, you'll go, okay, that doesn't matter. Or you'll go, I'm not putting a piece of each on the same card. Right. And it's also not quite as smooth. That's the thing that's kind of making me wonder. I don't mind cooler. cooler's fine, you know. Yes, it affects the envelopes, the 3x3s, the note cards and envelopes, and yeah, Whisper White, and they're already out of thick. Okay. Oh, I didn't know that. Well, that's because I wouldn't have ordered more than two anyway, because when the basic comes, I'm going to be flipping to that. And yeah, you can plan around it. You can, you know, vanilla is pretty. Yeah. But this uses Whisper White. And I thought, well, golly, we'll just do something. I've been yakking so much. Yeah, you can take that one way or the other. Yeah, you know what, Jacqueline, that is a really good thing. And just imagine that what the company's going through. You know, that could have been a family company that's been around for years, and then they got taken down by something that, over which they have no control. And so that's really bad. And about the smoothest, you know what? it's not going to bother me until it gets here. And then once we get used to the new one, we'll be happy with that. Because Stampin' Up! Wants to have a good product. Believe me, they don't move really fast, you know. So anyway, there. That's my opinion. If you'd like, I'll give you two. Okay, Jacqueline's down there in Australia. So what happens in Australia, you know, stays in Australia. I can't wait to go there. The U.S. has different issues. U.S. and Canada work on pretty much everything the same. Everything comes out of Riverton, Utah. Everything comes out of there anyway. And then Europe has their own warehouses, and so does the South. So, yeah. And when I mean the deep South, I mean Jacqueline South. Yeah. Hold on one second. Hold on. Yes, I like how you think, Patty. That's a really good point. For me, if you notice, most of the time I use a colored cardstock for my card base, and then I use colored cardstock for the card base, and then I use a white liner, which I rarely show you. Yes, yeah, that's true. You have your own warehouses, but everything comes. Yeah. Well, of course, your dyes and stuff probably come direct from China to you. I don't think they're going to come through us to you. But the things that we make and we cut our own cardstock. So it's, I don't know exactly how they do the other countries. I do know that we cut our own cardstock. I've seen the machine. It's huge. It's like almost as big as this room. Which this room is kind of small. Yeah, I love this house. It has big bedroom, front room's great, and the two bedrooms are tiny, so it's perfect for people who can squeeze their kids into like some, hey, it worked, our daughter, she survived. Oh yeah, you know, that's the way to think. And you know what, they want to have a quality product. They do not mess around. They do not mess around on that. Nope. So here we go. I'm going to do this at 4. Oh, look at that. Oh, you won't tell anyone that I spit on my cardstock, right? Oh, that's going to be on the back anyway. Okay, 4 1/4. Yeah, And it's going to go that way. So yeah, okay. So I'm going to go, for me, I haven't done one of these gatefold cards in a long time. So hey. So here it's 2 1/8. And then for me, I turn this around and then. Yeah. This is one of my new soul sisters here. And then here's 2 1/8. And I hope I put that on an eighth and not a quarter. You know, that talking and chewing gum at the same time can be really challenging. It looks the same. Let's double check. I overshot it a little bit. Now, here's the thing about, I was thinking about this when I was shampooing my hair today. First of all, you want to go, you fold towards the mountain, right? And if you're wondering why sometimes you are a little bit, you know, it's a little bit off, it's because no cardstock is exactly 8.5 by 11. No cardstock is exactly 12 by 12. So, you know, you like this. I'm like, you saw me, I went and I did it, but it's just a little bit off and oh golly. So now I'm going to turn this back because we're folding towards the mountain. Okay, well, we're going to throw that one away. Why did I go and do that in the middle? I told you about that talking and chewing gum at the same time. Okay, hold on one second. Back that up. You know, is there a way to edit these things? Okay, so two and an eighth. Oh, I love it. I love it. I love it. And when I do this, oh my goodness, Jacqueline did it, those exploding boxes. She did 15 of them. Yeah, they want to give you a quality product. They really do. I mean, look at how long we thought about the Stamparatus. I'm like, yeah. So here, okay. So I was thinking today when I was taking shampoo my hair. Oh, the lovely sheen. You know, if you did this at 2 1/2, or excuse me, 2 1/8, and then you didn't, I wonder how that would work, you know, and then you don't go and score this and then just bring it over, because you know how sometimes they don't meet exactly just right. Yeah. Golly, you guys aren't even making fun of my error. That's funny. Yeah. See, because that, boy, that is right up to it. Yeah, perfect. Of course, yeah. That's one of my gifts. Not taking life too seriously. Yeah. Except for I would like my dog in here. I wish he'd wake up. You wake him up? That's just not normal. That's just not normal. Now, I already cut this down. And here's the hard thing. Here's the hard thing. Is that I don't know whether this is around, you know, because that sale, I mean, it just kind of just blew everything out of the water. You know, it's just, wow. So I cut that down to 5 1/4. No, I did not. Don't tell me this is 5 1/4. I just grabbed a piece of card. No, that's 5 1/2. Okay. Hold on. We're going to cut it down to 5 1/4. Actually, I'm going to do it after I trim it. Now, you can go and put this directly on here. Let me, you know how we do our exercises in, oh, go ahead, make my day. Here, I can give you a lot of it. Yeah, that's the golf laugh. Yeah. Hi, Stamper. There's a couple different things to do it. You know, we like to do like experiments here. And if this is your first time here, you know, I don't always talk as much. No, that looks brass. But it does kind of, it matches that. You could, if you really like somebody, put, you know, mat it like that. Hi, Stamper. He's still getting used to this bed. Down. He's like, no, he thought down meant come over and see me. I wouldn't put black up next to this. There he goes. Yeah, see, I come back over here. That, if that was just a little bit, it's not the same. It's not quite the same, but it's good enough. You could also go in, you know, that's funny. You talk about that tail. His tail used to be nonstop. Now it's 3/4 of the time. Okay, so you could put this on here around the edge. Hey, no, we didn't get rid of it. We didn't get rid of it, and they do get washed on a regular basis. You could put, see, this will bring out that might be a good idea, but I'll bet you like the gold. So since I cut it on that other one, I'm going to cut it over there. See, is this the right, This is the right gold, which I just picked up whatever was over there. I am so glad that the brushed metal is going to be coming back. It's hard to know. It's like, it's this one, and I'm over here in the dark. Yeah, he's, his tail is just probably tired, because for many, many, many years, he's been wagging that tail. Okay, I think this is it. Here we go. 2 1/8. What's that? 1 7/8. Thank you for hanging out, hanging with me there. 5 1/4. Oh boy, it pays to go to church. Oh boy. Do you know when I cut this? Exactly the right amount was left over. Whoa. Yeah, baby. Now for this, because there's a little bit of... Yeah, she's talking about doodles. Doodles until she got arthritis. She was a champion tail wagger. Yeah. So this is 1 7/8 wide. And I'm going to use the extra strong stuff. Yeah. I'm going to use the extra strong stuff because there's a little bit of... There's a little bit of bend in this. Ooh, and clemmer. Yeah, this, it's doing weird things. And see, it's got that little bit there, but yeah. Doodles was Stamper's official girlfriend. Yeah. She wasn't exclusive, but we won't go there. Stamper was dedicated, because that's just how we roll around here. It's funny, you know, on a totally different subject. And here, now usually I go around the outside to make sure this is even. I've been dealing with dogs that are fixed so long that it looks funny when I see a male dog. I'm like, wow, what's that the package he's carrying? But when I do this one, I want it to be lined up with the top of that. If I can. Oh, see, look at, you can see where I broke my nail today. But I'm not going to let that get me. Okay, so I would think cutting this is more, okay, that was 1 7/8, right? If you're wondering where 1 7/8 is, because I know that the math part gets people, I just know it does. That's 2. And the itty bitty ones are 16ths, and the next one down that's halfway between this, right? Because these are 1/4 inches. So if you want an 1/8, you want to go halfway in between. Yeah. So there. We're still working on, oh golly, you know, this could work. Even though those are mellow moss. Mossy meadow. Okay, so what did I say? 1 7/8. That's going to be wide. 1 7/8. I'm going to cut this 1 1/2. One and a half. We'll see. If it's too small, it's just too small. And now this is where it's going to get weird, because I cut it Is it that way? There, that's the way it lines up. But I kind of want to take stuff off the top here and off the bottom here, but that's not going to be a good idea. So I'm just going to cut it off of here. So, you know, to think about these things, especially when this, because this has a pattern that flows together, and it may or may, if it's obvious, the only place this is really obvious is right here. But if I put this like this, you know, it may register with you on a certain level. So, golly, now I've 1 7/8, I went down to 1.5. So that's 3/8 off here. And Clemmer, I need to think and put my math hat on, and my math hat got left at the cleaners. All of a sudden my brain went blank. Hold on, let me take this with me. I think it's taken me this long to go in. Yeah, okay. Figure out where to cut something in. I don't know how long. And it's like my brain went just quit. Oh. That's close. If it's not right, it's close enough. All of a sudden I was like, oh my goodness, 7/8, because I had to do this on half of a measurement. And yeah, you know, on this is weird, but see, look at where this guy's full of things over here, and over here it's kind of, and you notice I cut it way down because I wanted that gold. I mean, honey, if you're paying for gold, you might as well show it. So what are we going to do? Because I do not have the mousse. I don't have the mousse. I don't have deer. If I do, I've forgotten about them. And I'm putting the strong stuff on here. Glue would be really nice because it would give you some hang time. Actually, I would have liked it over here, but it just wasn't rolling like that. You can't figure everything in, you know. Yeah. I like to get around the edges. I notice on this one, I tend to twist it a little bit, and that's what will make it go off the edge. So if you here's a learning time here. See, when you twist it like you're used to doing the snail adhesive, you take it down and then you twist it. Well, I've been doing that with this because if I twist, I flip it back, sometimes it rolls off more than I want because I'm probably not pushing down hard enough. So every now and then you're going to want to pull this over and make sure that stays in the middle, because if it keeps going over there, it's going to get way over there and you're going to go, wow, that's even harder to get back. So just remember that. But I really like this stuff when you're working with something that is, see, look at, I put that up at the top. No, put that at the bottom where people aren't really looking that close. Yeah, I don't know if I said that, but that's a good thing. Yeah, let the paper tell you where to put it. long as it doesn't say where the sun don't shine. So, yeah, I mean, I would think a nice little greeting right here in the middle. Nice little greeting here in the middle where you don't want to, like, I don't want to cover up most of these guys. Even something right here that says like Silent Night or where are we at? Oh, ho ho ho. Ho ho ho. See, look at it. Could just be this little Merry Christmas up here. And just let those guys, you know, be the, yeah, belly band would be great. I just don't want to cover up these. I mean, you know, I'm paying for gold here. Or, oh, if you're going to do, whoa, let's try it. Oh, we're going long today. As long as my foot hangs out. Here's the other thing. I think you can still get this. There is, this is what I'm looking at. I saw that the colored vellum from last year is it was still in the clearance rack. That would be nice. Well, wait a minute. Maybe not a big Christmas tree because we don't want to cover up those guys. No, we don't. I sometimes keep this in here. Apparently I did on this one. See, that's too loud in the middle of the night. Hey, now this one could go down here. You know I'm going to finish this later. I have a feeling maybe. I'm just looking at options. Yeah. I like it that you helped me. See, look at. You could take a water painter. And color, well, yeah, we don't have the white glimmer paper anymore, do we? But if you have some glimmer paper and you could color that, a nice pear pizzazz, yeah, that would be nice. Yeah, see, this is too big. But this is just right. Wow, I could just do one. Wow. Who knows? Okay, we're going to do the lazy way here. I can remember when this came out, Pear Pizzazz, but how about soft seafoam? Hold on, let's see what that looks like. Yeah, here I was thinking soft seafoam was an in color. You know, I do get more confused. I've never put these two together. This is more of a yellow. This is more of a blue, but let's see. Yeah, of course I'm going to do it on the inside when you're not looking. Yeah, okay, there's the light. Don't do this at home. I never do. Okay, so. I think it's in my head how I'm going to finish it. Sometimes I just have to be quiet after the fact. Yeah. I'm going to do two of these because I'm not sure which one. Belly band, Connie, that's a good question. Belly band is where you cut like an inch wide piece of cardstock. And what would be nice, if you were going to do it on this, I would do it out of vellum so that you could see through it. Because I really like these. You know, I think that the gold is a really working thing here. And then you attach it and put it around. And then you would put the seam, like you would put like a focal point over it and put the seam behind that, not in the back. Of course, we could do one. Wouldn't that be nice? Okay, so here is soft seafoam. Yeah, why did I do these both on the same one? That was not the smartest thing I've done today. But I think that's the right color. Don't do this at home. Oh, yeah, that was smart, Anne. I went and put the... See, normally I wouldn't have put a lighter one. Yeah, I don't have the kit right here, I think. Right where I can put my hand on it, but I had the paper. Yeah. See, this one's darker. Yeah. And then... Hold on, this might not be, I might have to like make a noise here. There it is. You know, mistake. You know, you try to keep things organized and stuff. I got all my old Christmas stuff down there. Well, guess what? It doesn't get used because here I have, this is just might be the perfect thing. Itty bitty Christmas. Itty bitty Christmas, because all you need is a small thing here, you know. Happy Christmas. That you know, that's something that just, whoa, look at that. And actually, you know what? You could tie a ribbon around this, tie a belly band, and since, you know, since we were talking about belly bands, let's just show her how to make one real quick. How long this one is. I have no idea how long this is. Oh, but that was vanilla. Hold on. I keep all of my... Just made it an inch because that was easiest to measure. I keep all of my Whisper White, Very Vanilla, and Black in assorted sizes. But the one I had, it was either vanilla. See, look at, you just take this and you just make sure that it's longer. This I did is 1 inch by 11, and yeah, you could go and you could measure this. Yeah, you could. Yeah, but that might be too much like right. This might be just, you know, what you do and what you, you know, and it's nice if you have a little bit of leeway there, but on this, I'm going to cut off like that much, right? Right there. What's that, an inch and a half? Let's see how close I was. It's an inch and a quarter, okay? I haven't gotten to the part where I'm going to be having more room here. You know where that piece of paper went, cardstock went, it went on the floor. Yeah. And if a better idea is not to go and cut it, fold it really tight to it, because so that you don't want it so tight that they can't flip it off. Flip it off. Yeah, okay. And for this, you definitely want to use Tear and Tape, which is right here. I put one here. Unless you want it to flip open. So I've got put one here, and then I put one here. What would have been nicer is just use some old olive. That would have been, yeah. But I just want to show you this. And I would like put it around here so that you know that because you can make it as loose as you want. I don't know, what's this garbage in here? Yeah, you know, we could put the camera down here so that you could, rather than look at the top of my head, you would look at my my face, but then I'd have a double chin all the time. So there you go. Yeah. But like I said, it would probably look better in gold or green. And then you could just go and put something like, well, here, let's make it easy. Because you know, I'm going to finish this later because, our time is, we're doing more. Oh, yeah. But these are done in Mossy Meadow. And I don't want to be too many greens in here. Whoa, that's one way. And then put a little Believe across that. Wow, that's not too bad, but definitely make this out of the green. Yeah, in fact, that's just might be the way I do it. Yeah, and see, Jacqueline, you know, one of these days we'll get Stampin' Up to sell Velcro dots, and then what are we gonna do? Or you can use small magnets. Yeah. Yeah, so there, you know, hey, but yeah, you know, they do have that vellum, and it's in the clearance rack. Hold on. Let me see if I can find it real quick. So by the way, oh yeah, let me tell you, we've got a new shopping code, and you definitely want to use that when you shop, because, well, I've got something going on that only people that are in Stamper's Dog Pound know about, and on my clients on my mailing list. So hold on, and close out. Let me just go and yeah, and so you can see this. There you go. That's kind of there. When you can't find something, and I'm sorry that this cuts off part of it, go up here to search. There's a little, see that little search thing up there? And just type in, hey, you don't, vellum, there it is, perennial elegance. There you go. There's the number 149101. And you can see where something like that would be a nice little thing to have, and especially at $4, I mean, that's really not, you know, that's not a lot. And so there are still things on the closeout, and so look at this, 149101. That was $11. You're gonna get a couple sheet, I think it's, let me look at this real quick. Four sheets of each color. Old olive, petal pink, and so saffron. And so when you want to put something on there that you can see through, but it still has color, that would be a great thing to look at. So, hey, I hope you had a good time and that you learned something today. You know, I will be back on Monday at 1:00 Pacific time. I hope the world is treating you well. And if it's not, hey, wear a mask. That might be a little bit nicer. Hey, this is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from stamperdog.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun yes. into your day.